Thursday. I sense a little trend here. I find that every time I pick up the camera to vlog, it's actually the day before my night shift. Today, I have a night shift tonight at midnight. I'm at a different hospital, so the night shift starts at a slightly different time. And I just happened to wake up and I was like, I'm gonna vlog today. So I think it's because on the day of the night shift, I have all day free and usually it's like a pretty good time for me to vlog and do everything that I need to do. So as usual, the night before my night shift, I try to get as much sleep in as possible. So I tried to stay up last night, but I could only stay up until I think maybe like 1 or 1:30. So even though I try to stay in bed as long as possible, I was up by like 10, which isn't bad. I think I'm gonna try to take a nap a little later so that I can stay up tonight from midnight to 8 a.m. when I am done with my shift. So I have two night shifts in a row tonight, Thursday night and Friday night, and then I have the whole weekend off, which is awesome. Just gonna vlog my day, talk about different things. I wanted to kind of answer some of your more frequently asked questions about my rotations and things like that. So let's get started. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is what's in my white coat. I washed my white coat yesterday, so I took everything out from the pocket. So I have a bunch of stuff laid out here. So I thought it would be a great time to show you guys what I carry in emergency medicine. Things that are in my pocket really vary from rotation to rotation because depending on what you're doing, hi Candy. Because depending on what you're doing, the things that are in your pocket just varies. First thing I have is my stethoscope. In the emergency room, you really just need any stethoscope. It doesn't have to be like a super fancy brand. I've seen a lot of people just use sort of the disposable ones. I've seen people use super fancy like Lippmann Cardiology, really everything in between. So the one I have is MDF. Next, I have all these pens. I've had attendings ask me for pens and then, you know, they forget and then I don't get them back. So I try to have a lot of pens on me. I have these two Multipens, which can be found in my store. And I have just a black one and like a cheap blue one. Next to the pens, I have a pen light. Usually in the emergency room, you end up using the otoscopes that are attached on the walls to kind of look into people's eyes and ears and whatever. Sometimes the patients are in the hallways and you just need to be able to check them regardless, even if there's no otoscope. So I carry my own pen light. This thing I haven't really used, but I've been keeping it in my pocket. I got it from Muji in Korea. It's actually a... Let me show you guys. It's actually like scissors. Pretty cool. I haven't really used it because I always carry my shears with me. This is used to cut people's clothing off when a trauma comes in and you need to evaluate everything on their body. Hold on one second. Okay, Candy. It's also useful for cutting tape, cutting whatever you might be doing, maybe splinting somebody and you need to cut the stockinette, or if you need to cut some of the splinting material, that's great. So I carry this with me all the time. In terms of some of the other medical equipment, it's kind of like what ends up in my pocket and I end up not using. The other day I helped with the central line placement, so I have my Sero gloves. My size is 6.5. And then I think the time before that, oh, Candy. The time before that, there was a guy getting a chest tube. So the person who was doing it needed like a thicker thing to kind of secure the tube. So they needed a tube of silk. So I had that in my pocket. We ended up not using it because I had more than one. These are steri strips, which is good for kind of closing and keeping the wound closed once you suture or don't suture, depending on what the wound is. So I had that in my pocket. It is probably no good to use anymore, but it's the tetracaine that you would use to, if somebody came in with something in their eyes and they felt like there is some like a foreign body in their eyes and we need to use fluorescein to look into their eyes. So it's basically like a fluorescent dye that you put on their eyes. And you use a special lamp to see if there's a foreign body. Tetracaine is used as like a numbing medicine on the eye, so it's like drops. So I have that in my pocket. Always good to have some tape here. This is just a regular fabric tape, always very useful. And in terms of taking notes and taking patients' histories, I used to use a notebook, and I think the notebook, it's called Perfect HMP or something like that. And I've talked about it before in my previous videos. That's very useful when you're first starting out and you don't want to forget any history questions. But once you get used to asking all the questions and you kind of don't need to use a notebook anymore, it's something that's really simple to use. It's just basically like computer printer paper that I fold like this. And then I have all the information that I need here and then maybe here. I've seen residents use like very tiny font and they'll have like 4 patients in one side, and I'm not there yet, so I tend to use a whole page for one patient, and I have usually 4 or 5, 5 or 6 when I first start my shift, and then I take my notes there. This is something that I just got the other day during a noon lecture. It's all the medications and dosages that you need for intubation, post-intubation, if someone's coming in with a seizure or someone's coming in with anaphylaxis. So I thought it was something that it's just good to have on hand. I should eventually memorize all of this, but I don't have it memorized yet. So I just have the piece of paper with me in my pocket. And lastly, this is the MRAP basics. Basically, this is divided into complaints that people come in with to the emergency room. So headache, all the things that it can be, what physical exams that you need to do, and what's the treatment for them. So this is super handy, especially if you're just starting out in emergency medicine. So head injury, altered mental status, dizzy, lightheaded, which is like sometimes like the most nebulous thing that people just come in with and I have no idea what to do. This really helps me figure out like how to approach this complaint. And lastly, this pocketbook emergency medicine book. A lot of people use purple one for internal medicine. I think it's a purple one, but they have one for emergency medicine. It's kind of similar to this small booklet where everything is like kind of complaint based, and it tells you how to examine and what the etiology is, what the pathophysiology is, and how to treat it. So this I just kind of read like a book. It's like too, there's like too much information for me to be just like looking things up really quickly. I use like this for that mostly, but I have this on hand, so if I have any downtime, I can just like read through and like learn more about different things. That's all the things that I have for in my pocket. It gets pretty heavy, but they all come in pretty handy, so I like having them on me. I'll put all the information in the description box below. Well, I'm gonna eat something because I'm pretty hungry, probably some breakfast food. You guys didn't see this, I had to film that like 3 times because Candy kept on getting on top of the table and just like getting on top of all the stuff that I had laid out. So I'm gonna feed Miss Candy because I think she's hungry too, and I'm gonna have some cereal. I like to have 2 types of cereal with me on hand at all times. This is just personal preference. Here, move Candy. I like to have like a granola-y, like nutty cereal, and then I like to have something a little sweet. This one is called Love Grown Chocolate Power O's, and these are actually made with beans. So all these different types of beans, but they actually still end up being like pretty chocolatey and doesn't taste beany at all. I like this one, and I like this one from Post, which is the banana nut crunch flavor. I'm gonna have one of these. So I just made a bunch of these strawberries and blueberry bowls. This small one is great for bringing them with you to the hospital. This big one I'm gonna keep at home and eat from it at home. Yeah, so at like Whole Foods or any kind of grocery stores, they already make these like pre-made strawberries and blueberry packages, but they tend to be a lot more expensive, so I like to just buy them separately and just make them myself. They're super easy and fast, and it's like a great way to get some fruit in your diet when you're out and about. And yeah, so these are my little fruit bowls. So next I'm gonna make some curried cauliflower. So I'm just gonna wash it, cut them into little pieces, and mix them with curry powder and olive oil, and I'm gonna air fry them for a little bit, and they turn out really delicious. So these are the ingredients that I'm gonna be adding. Just some extra virgin olive oil, kosher salt, Madras curry powder, and some black pepper. So I have the mixed cauliflower here, and I'm just gonna dump it into the air fryer. Give it a
good shake. And I'm just gonna kind of fudge the time and the temperature because I just don't really know. But I'm gonna put it at 15 minutes at the highest setting, and I'll check back in like 7 minutes or so to see how it's doing. All right, that looks really, really good. And it smells really good too. Look at that. So I have my cauliflower here, and I have a little project to work on. So now that I'm in rotations, like away rotations, I don't necessarily have homework, but I have projects that I have to do and some readings that I have to stay on top of. So that's what I'm gonna do now for the next couple hours. I've decided to go on a fun little outing today. Bumper to bumper. Can't really see what happened though. That guy's wearing scrubs. I think he has to go to the hospital, and now he's just gonna walk. No excuses. Gotta get to work. Super bright. I had to get out of the car because we were stuck in that traffic for so long that my boyfriend had to go. So I'm just going by myself to Lower East Side. Gonna get something to eat and something to drink, and then head back home. I'm back. It is now almost 8 o'clock. I took a little detour and got a pedicure as well. Hashtag treat yourself. So I have about 4 hours before I have to leave for my shift. So I think I might just take a quick nap if I can and then head out to my shift. Hey guys, so it is 11:15. I'm gonna head out now. I'm gonna come back tomorrow morning and try to vlog before I go to sleep and tell you guys some of the things that I see, and then I'm gonna close the vlog then. So I will head out to my shift and I will see you guys in about 8 to 9 hours. Good morning, everyone. Actually, not morning at all. It's actually like 2 p.m. right now. I meant to finish my vlog or close my vlog yesterday or earlier this morning when I got home, but I was just so exhausted that by the time I thought of it, I was already in bed and I was so comfortable, so I didn't want to get up and vlog. So I'll just tell you guys a little bit about my shift before I close this vlog. So my shift was from midnight to 8 a.m. It's actually a pretty slow night, which was good. I had a couple different types of patients. I had a patient who came in. She was like a post-surgery patient. She had surgery a couple days ago and she was having some reaction to morphine that she was taking. She ended up being okay. I had another patient who was pregnant, and she was like 16 weeks pregnant, and she had like a single pill episode, so that's obviously concerning. So that patient, I did an ultrasound on my own and I saw the baby and I saw the baby's heart moving, and that was very exciting. The patient actually started to cry when she saw the baby like on the ultrasound machine, so like a very like nice touching moment to know that the baby was okay. So I had a patient who got hit by a car while he was biking. Fortunately, it wasn't a major trauma. He just had some abrasions on his arm and his torso. I also did a fast exam on him. That's the ultrasound exam that you do to make sure there's no internal bleeding. So I think those were the patients that I was like directly responsible for, and there are a few other patients that I just kind of like watch from the side. Sorry I couldn't bring you guys in the hospital. You guys understand it's like a patient privacy HIPAA thing. I can't really film in the hospital. I know some of you guys have asked me why I can't film, that's why. But hopefully me telling you guys about it is interesting enough. Thank you guys so much for watching this vlog. I will see you guys in the next video. Bye. Truth is, I really don't mind. Only got my youth for a minute, no lie. Gotta put the use, millennial.